know nothing about the universe. Our understanding of physics is kindergarten, if that. Daylight come. During the Reagan years, the Star Wars program took a technological leap forward of incredible magnitude. I mean, we're talking a leap of understanding. Real experiment called Gravity Probe B. It was actually a time travel experiment that was launched to use photons as inertial frame dragging and send bits of information back in time by a few milliseconds to prove time travel was possible. The whole thing was funded by the National Science Foundation. I think it cost something like $23 million to put this thing up in space. I was in California, actually working at Lawrence Livermore National Labs. A very interesting relationship amongst a few of these top-level sort of inner circle guys there at Livermore. I worked there for 2 years, basically, and working on this cold fusion project that I don't think it was classified or isn't now. Maybe it was. Who knows? They are very closed-minded. I know they're closed-minded. One of the fellows I sat next to, he was the top physicist. I became real good friends with him. Something was going on there. Something really, really freaking weird. He was like a scared animal most of the time. This guy, he was practically scared of his own shadow. He's telling the story, very unique theory of the nature of photons, which match perfectly with the discussion that my father and I had that perhaps unified electromagnetics and gravitation. This can be scaled up to the size of a starship, scaled down to a suit you wear that can allow you to float freely across a desert floor. It's a question very worthy of pursuit. But it all comes down to the same fundamental idea. We're moving a particle, an element, a wavefront of energy. We're moving that wavefront. And the interaction of that wavefront with the fundamental quantum field. And when you achieve that condition, you're going to generate a force. And I think there might be something here of extraordinary significance.